Hi everyone, Chef of Mud was in the Low Countries. Now in one of my early videos you see me doing the sharpening of the blades of this device, the DeWalt D27300 planar thicknesser. And with the Tourmaker it takes me quite some time to get out a deep nick in those blades. So that was why I was very interested when I saw an offer online that is selling three of these sets of blades for only 95 euros. I will put the link into this offer into the description. And you can also see it above in the video. So this is a very interesting offer because normally one set costs about 70 euros. So this is about 32 euros per set. It's a high-speed steel made in Germany. So I'm very interested in doing a test. Take the old one out, put one of those sets in, readjust the blades and do some first tests to see how they are doing. So let's unpack it. So here you can see it, 260 by 12 by 3 millimeters, high speed steel, mid Einstein nut. That is the thing over here where you can make it the proper adjustment. Made in Germany, nicely oiled, greased up, which of course is a good thing, so they don't have any corrosion. Let's do a quick test. This is already quite good. That sounds quite good. Let's put him in and do some early tests into the wall. Even the sides are very sharp. To be careful with your fingers. So as you can see, every knife has four bolts with 10 millimeter wide heads that you have to release in order to get the knife out. And here it is. These are the original knives from DeWalt. This is the adjustment nut. Einstellnut, as the Germans call it. So let's clean it out a little. Also clean this one a little bit out. Adjustment nut fits fine. Let's see if I can get it back into place. Second attempt. It looks more like it. Now for the adjustment I will use the tool that has been delivered by DeWalt, where you need to put it onto the roller and then the knife should just touch it very lightly on the inside. When the knives are too high, you can see that the tool is able to rock a little bit, and when it's too low, the knives won't touch. So that's the whole idea behind it. And when I now put the tool on, you can see that the knives are a little bit too high because indeed I'm able to rock the tool. So the knife has to go down. So also the slit of the knife helps you a little bit in this, because the eye is very sensitive for this type of slits. Don't put the knives too high, because if you do that, then the intake roll will not be able to take it in. That's what I saw with the initial setting of the DeWalt.
And that's it. First knife mounted. So let's now also take out the other knife as well. Make sure that there's not too much play on the knives, but don't fixate it, because then you cannot adjust the knives anymore, but also you don't want to have too much play on it. Now the knives will be too high here as well. You can really see the rocking of the tool. The knives are quite high. Also when you turn it a little bit, you can see there that there's very thick edge. So we're going to reduce the edge. Now I cannot shift the knives properly, so I'm going to make this a little bit less. So I should shift the knife. Yeah, now I can shift the knife. That's also a sign that you can now also adjust it properly. I'm going to drop it down a little bit. There it goes. Yep. So you can see the slit is now properly same as the previous one. Fits fine with the tool. So we can now really fixate. Don't also forget to fixate the adjustment screws as well, because you might lose them otherwise.
So the original knives have been replaced with the new ball knives. I'm going to store the old knife back to the little bag that came along with it, because it fits very nice. And I'm also going to grease it up. Make sure there's no corrosion. Before putting it away. Now the next step, of course, is to do some tests to see how well the knives are doing in the plane of the device or at the thicknesser. So I'm going to hook up the exhaust and do some first tests. And I'm very curious what the result will be. First I'm going to take this piece, it has already been planed before, but I will do it again and see how it works. I did some first tests, it showed okay, here's a little bit coarse, but this is quite nice. I'm going to do now a second test with some serious work. This is the original status. This is after planing, so it's quite smooth. Some coarse areas a little bit here, but it's quite smooth. Very nice. So with these two pieces of cherry wood, I will test to the world both planer and thicknesser properties with the new knives. So let's change the planer into the thicknesser and also test that performance. So here we see the results. With the cheap knives, they look nice,
they are square. So they function well inside of the vault. No reason why not to buy them. Of course, I don't know anything about whether they will hold for a long time. If there are any interesting things to mention there, I will update you in another video. But for now, I think the results are quite good. And I'm happy with this new set of knives. Now, especially when you have a deep nick, like for example with a nail or a screw, it can take quite some effort to get them sharpened again, doing it by yourself using a Tormach. So in that sense, it's good to know that there's also a cheap alternative with those knives. So we hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.